All right, let's get into it. Today we're watching Seven Rappers Who Got Checked by Other Rappers by Trapologist. Let's see who's really, really getting pressed, who really, really bout it. I don't know who really bout it back here, but a lot of rappers be talking crazy, so, you know, I just want to see what's up. Feel me? Let's get into it. I knew it was going to start off with this guy, though. You know what I'm saying? This is the regular... You know what I'm saying?
Finally! TT's got you! Fine! Fine!
Who's that?
Come to the corner, man!
These are times rappers check their ops. And first, we got to start with Dougie B and K-Flock because they saw one of their ops at a concert and checked them.
K-Flock. Are they talking about Rolling Loud? Yep, they talking about Rolling Loud. I was dead ass there, bro. I was dead there. I was right there, and then I left. I was backstage, then I left to go to the media pit where they was doing like the interviews and stuff, and then I get word that they just had a whole brawl, bro.
The beefing was for the crazy. Past few months after K-Flock claimed to be the king of Bronx drill. So Suno clapped back, claiming that he was the one who started the wave and that K-Flock was just copying his style.
If you're the king of the Bronx, you better show me more than 100K or better, you heard?
Nah.
I don't gotta do no drills. That's gonna do that for me. Respect.
Remember,
I just say they
started this. Go down. Slow the down.
Yo, I always thought about like videos like this, like how the cameraman feel. Like the cameraman just pointing like this, bro. The whole time they talking crazy. The cameraman's just like that. Yo, y'all look mad hard right now, bro. Keep going, gang. Nah, this gonna do it. I'm crying. Let's get it.
And Ron Suno felt disrespected when K-Flock called himself the king of Bronx drill, since Suno has been rapping longer than K-Flock.
I don't hate on no man. Anybody that's doing their thing, respectfully, come on. I never said is not doing their thing, but pay homage. If you got a formula for something, you gotta say where you got it from. Come on, boy. Yeah, box braids.
All right, you can't say somebody copy you because of box braids, bro. Box braids is like a regular. Your man's got box braids. He copy you? Come on now. That's not. All right, whatever. You feel me? I ain't gonna go too deep into it.
Square up like me. Tell me, yo, what's my mother? The next I see is getting knocked out. What am I mother?
Then, not long after the dissing on social media, K-Flock and Dougie B ended up bumping into Ron Suno at Rolling Loud in New York. And it was on site. Supposedly, Suno went up to them to try and talk it out. But after the disrespectful things he said online, K-Flock and Dougie B weren't feeling it, and things got crazy. After the scuffle, Dougie B went on Instagram Live to give his side of the story.
In your face, you all like, yo, what's up, though? Yo, you good, though? Yeah, we here. What the fuck you talking about? You putting out...
Ron Suno responded by posting a video claiming that K-Flock and Dougie B didn't do anything.
We all bullying. Why you backing up? Dougie said.
I can't do this, bro. Like, I feel like arguing over the net. Well, videos just look weird. I don't know, bro. Let me just stop, bro. Let me just stop. Let me just stop.
They got big.
And thankfully, no one was harmed in this situation. But now, let's move on to Offset.
Yeah, there's no weapons.
He had to check a rapper for disrespecting his wife. Because back in 2018, Chicago rapper King Yella dropped a song named...
Who the fuck is this guy? Oh, nah. He dead got a picture of her. That's tough.
Cardi B Truth over the beat from Offset's Ric Flair Drip and rap, driving in the foreigns. And you know I love Mercedes. Thick Cardi
King
B.
Yella.
Wanna have my baby. He continued by saying,
"Who the fuck
Yella,
is King Yella?
Don't play that. Offset boy, you better watch your boy. She on my." Yella also put up an.
Why is this nigga talking so smooth? Better watch your boy. She on my. Why he's talking so smooth, bro?
A picture of him and Cardi B together. Offset obviously wasn't cool with the situation, and a video came out of him threatening to put his hands on King Yella on FaceTime.
Yo, inbox him up. It's called my. I'm a bozo. Don't give no about none of that. You said what? You said what?
Nah, nigga, you know you hear him, bro. You said what? I'm gonna beat your ass. I can hear him clearly. And you right there in real time. How can you not hear him, bro? He said, I'm gonna beat your ass. Why you keep saying,
Who? Who? This nigga being scary, bro.
Like, I'm not worried about no.
It sounds like you were worried, bro.
And posted a phone call.
I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. Cardi look mad different right here, bro. Am I bugging?
With Yella.
That look like Cardi, yes. But that looks different from the Cardi now.
Well, she told him.
So keep my name out your dirty mouth, you dirty.
Damn.
Like, doing the most.
That's one thing a New York girl gonna tell you, bro. If she not jacking you, she gonna call you dirty. Shit crazy.
Right up.
The situation cooled off after that, and in 2022, King Yella did an interview with 16 Shot'em Vision.
This nigga got the White Sox logo on his face, Gucci logo on his face, LV logo on his face, a music note by his lip. Nah.
And addressed the whole thing.
I had seen, like, you had a relationship with Cardi B and like that. How that come about?
I met Cardi in like 2013. At the time, I ain't know who she was. She knew who I was. You feel me? I ain't know who she was, though.
When 16 shot him, asked him straight up if he had a history with her, Yella finally squashed the rumors since he got pressed by Offset.
Did you smash Cardi B?
Man, that boy's scared.
No, man, I ain't had
I copped it.
I just tagged Offset and said we been having so I never said anything, you know.
And the video gets even crazier because Lil Baby ends up pressing a rapper about not having his money. But first, let's talk about Detroit rapper Skilla Baby. Because one day, Skilla was at the recording studio and spotted GMO Stax, one of his known ops. And once Skilla spotted Stax, he started trying to press him. And that's when things started getting more serious. So the studio owner made them go outside so they wouldn't mess up anything in the studio. And no one knows what happened outside, but GMO and his crew ended up snatching Skilla's chain and doing a lot more. Skilla was also outnumbered in the situation, because a few days later, Stax went live on Instagram flexing with Skilla's chain.
He say y'all some.
Yo, imagine your op snatching chain, right? Imagine your op snatching chain, right? And then you know your chain not legitimate for me, so they snatch your chain and then diamond test your shit on live. Oh my god. Oh, everybody got die. Oh my god. Oh, you done. That's your whole rap career right there. That's tough. Everybody gotta go down. That is tough, bro. That is super tough. It's all after that.
Look at these little Skilla ended up addressing the situation.
That's tough.
With Say Cheese. And he said,
looked like it was 3 or 4 guys approaching you in the studio. It looked like you were by yourself.
I approached them. They know what happened. I know what happened. Everybody can say what they want about it.
Yeah, I got something. I approached them.
I don't be thinking about, I know everybody think about jewelry and shit like that. I don't think about that shit when I get mad. That shit materialistic. They got off.
Good mindset.
It is what it is.
Now let's move on to when Lil TJ got pressed by a Toronto rapper named Top 5 for not checking in with him before he came to his city. Top 5.
All right. Okay. Wait a minute. Full disclosure. I'm not trying to disrespect nobody from the 6. But I'll be damned if I check in to go to Toronto, bro. That's crazy. Your Canadians is known for being nice. Why am I checking in? I thought y'all was going to be nice people. Why am I checking in, bro? Why are y'all trying to harm a nigga in Toronto, bro? Like, I can get LA, because LA, it be going down. But Toronto, though? That's crazy, bro. Checking in Toronto is insane, bro. No disrespect, though, for me. So Top 5, you know what I'm saying?
Posted a video of him trying to press TJ on the street.
Fuck! What? Them GG's got you! Fuck! Fuck, poof!
I'm crying.
Come to the corner, then. Stop doing it for the camera. Come to the corner.
Lil TJ obviously wasn't too worried about the situation and started dancing for the camera. TJ also started posting videos of him going all over Toronto without any issue.
I'm calling like this my city, man. I'm getting them all for like another 2 hours, so come pull up with me.
This nigga moving devious.
He posted Top 5 on social media. He posted screenshots of Top 5 sliding into someone's DM.
Nigga said, yo, bro, how much to open for TJ in Toronto? I'm dead serious. I'll send deposit soon. You tell. Said, fam, I'll drop 100. What? 2K? Like, to open up. Just do that for me, fam. Respect, fam. You know the city will go crazy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Damn! 12 messages, bro, in the DMs is nasty work, bro. To try to press a nigga, you just mad. You got mad after. I'll be mad after 4. Then you sent 8 more after 4, bro. That's where all that anger in that video was coming from, for real, for real. That's these 8 messages, every message was just another just level of madness. Like, yeah. It's a madness and badness, bro. This is tough. Begging you look like a groupie in a nigga DM.
He even
bro,
offered to send
tough.
A couple of racks just to get put on, but TJ turned him down, and that's when the issue started. Luckily,
like,
nothing
what?
Serious happened, but people didn't realize how deadly it could have been. Top 5 is facing a murder charge right now, and there's no telling what would have.
Oh, Top 5, my fault, bro. He looked like a.
Realize how deadly.
He looked like a Zeman in there. Like, look, he looked like a Zeman. My fault, bro. Hey, yo, top five. Is that what Drake was talking about? Top five. Yo, top five, my fault, bro. My G.
A murder charge right now. And there's no telling what would have gone down if TJ had followed him around the corner. Lil Uzi Vert also had to press one of his ops in 2017. Lil Uzi Vert also had to press one of his ops in 2017.
What the fuck, Uzi? That's flamboyant ass pole.
Uzi was having major issues with his label, so he made a tweet about the problems. A couple hours later, Rich the Kid hopped on Twitter.
Oh yeah, Rich the Kid.
Why you should have signed Rich Forever. And Uzi took that as disrespect, so he quoted his tweet saying, "Boy, I'm not signing for 20 racks." Then a few days later, Rich went on the cruise show and turns things up. The host asked him if he'd sign Uzi, and Rich told him, "Not right now, due to personal reasons." Uzi took that as disrespect and responded to Rich in the weirdest way possible, since he posted a picture of him holding a huge crab and tagged Rich the Kid as the crab. Then Rich ended up making the beef official when he dropped the song Dead Friends.
Dead Friends.
You gotta be a boss. You a middleman.
You a little man.
Your money getting short. Rich also flexed how much money he was making and how
money
Uzi was
shorter.
Missing out
your
by not signing with him. Uzi clapped back with the song Rich Forever and told Rich the Kid he wasn't the one to mess with. He also made fun of Rich's hairline with the bar, "These, oh yeah, their hairline's receding." Uzi would also go on to diss Rich on a few more songs, so it was real smoke between the two. And Uzi and Rich were both scheduled to perform at the Roots Picnic in Philly. Uzi ended up spotting Rich on the street and hopped out of his car to press him.
Nigga pulled up with a t-shirt and sweats. 1v7, bro, and still want it.
The video cuts off, but then another taken right after showed Uzi popping off at Rich inside a Starbucks. And not long after that, someone released a video of Rich running down the street trying to get away from Lil Uzi.
Nah!
Even though he got caught on camera running, Rich posted a video later and said,
"Pulled up and did what? Did what? Walk around."
You dead ass right now, gang. Come on. Come on, bro. I never even seen this video, bro. That's just bad. That's just bad, bro.
Like this. Walk around Philly like this.
Nigga, so we got all Philly. That went down. Rich posted on his IG story. All fun and games till somebody get. Then it's tragic. And after the Philly incident,
tragic, new panic.
Pretty much died. Subscribe quickly if you're enjoying the video. But let's move on to when Lil Baby had to press a rapper about his money. Because YK Osiris randomly became famous for owing other rappers money. And back in November 2021, Osiris ran into Lil Baby at the jewelry store. And Baby pressed him over the 5 racks he owed him.
That's sorry, let me get my 5 in, bro.
You just, hey, I probably see the day. I can't wait. I can't wait to get you. I can't.
Are you right now?
He's so funny. He's so funny, man.
At first, Osiris tried
to
laugh
it off, man.
He said he couldn't wait to pay him back. But then Baby got more serious about it and asked him how long he owed him. It's unclear what he owed Baby for, but that's not the only rapper he had debts with. A month after the video with Baby came out, Drake made Osiris perform his track, Worth It, to clear off the 60 racks he owed him.
I'm not Baby, I'm not Boosie. You don't owe me no 2 racks, 5 racks. You owe me 60 bags? I'm playing the song right now.
60,000! Niggas borrowed 60,000 from Drake, bro. Yo, Drake, can I get 60,000, my guy? Please, my God. Changed my whole life. I ain't even gonna lie to you.
You ready?
I ain't even gonna lie to you.
I need a full. No huh? You don't owe me no money right now. I swear, I need a full performance though. The real though.
I ain't gonna lie to you. I ain't even gonna cap. If I was told to perform to clear 60 bands, I'm doing it. Alright, yo, but nah, that's dumb funny though. Nigga really performed, bro.
Nigga really performed, bro.
And it seems like all the money issues have left him without any friends in the rap game. Because back in October, he went live on IG and revealed that he doesn't rock with Drake, Lil Baby, or anyone else in the industry anymore.
Y'all keep using that Drake, Drake don't fuck with me either. Me and Drake don't talk. Me and the baby don't talk. Nobody in to Osiris.
Fans were worried about him because Osiris was breaking down into tears since he felt like everyone was fake to him.
Money, bro.
Hopefully, damn. Osiris can get back to a happier place in life and find some real friends in the industry. Lil Durk also had to press someone back in 2014 because Durk and Tyga.
2014 is crazy.
And Tyga featured Tyga? The game on his track to Durk called Chirac to LA. And the gang was talking disrespectful on the track because he said, Tyga hit me like Durk dissing, Durk Nowitzki, Durk who? Never heard of these. Then, not long after the track dropped, a video came out showing Durk pressing the game at a club in LA. Both of their crews were yelling at each other. Durk and his people were really ready for the smoke. And a day after that went down, the game hopped on Twitter, letting everyone know.
Damn, that nigga wrinkled it. Oh, wait, hold on. I ain't talking about the game. Keep going, my boy.
But later, the game went on an interview and made it seem like he tracked Durk down and ignored him after he saw how small he was.
We found him. We went to him, and I saw Durk, and he was a little guy, man, and he was cool, man. So it just went away, man.
After the interview, Durk hopped on Twitter and tweeted, "He found me, LOL, with the and glad I'm not a Twitter gangster." It looked like the beef was going to spark up even more this time. But after that, neither one of them sent more shots at each other. Durk also spoke about what happened in an interview with DJ Vlad, but he kept it short.
Club scene was more like, that's our first time seeing each other, that asshole was tension. You know what I'm saying? He had his people had tension, we had tension. So we just brought it to the middle of the club, called it a big scene. But at the end of the day, it was street politics.
Gucci Mane also had to check one of his artists since he was talking crazy and disrespecting him. Because in 2019, Gucci ended up signing Atlanta rapper Ola Runt. Since he liked his style and the way he sounded, Gucci even ended up hopping on a few songs with Ola since Gucci was trying to help Ola make it into the rap game. And one day, Ola and Gucci were on an IG live together, and Gucci was letting Ola know he might finish another song they were working on later that night when he had time. But Ola started talking crazy and trying to press Gucci since Gucci said he might finish it that night.
I might do that. Feel like you
up tonight. And don't keep saying Mike, man. I need you to do that, man. I'm FaceTime me.
Nah, you doing that bull like you act like you can't listen. But now it's some music, but you ready to do the music though. Say anything else you talking about. You tried me earlier, you told the phone what you told me.
Nah, man, we don't
really
lie.
Strong. I really feel tried.
Nah, we ain't gonna do all that on live, man.
I was gonna tell me, hey, friend of business, don't try to run my life.
And Gucci later dropped.
Nigga's stupid for that. I ain't gonna cap.
Ola, since Ola didn't like to listen and was very disrespectful. And since getting dropped, his career hasn't had much of a buzz. But if you thought that was crazy, click this video to see Times rappers outsmarted the police.
Hey, man. Say, man. That was seven rappers who got checked by other rappers. I ain't gonna lie to you. That was pretty good content. I ain't gonna lie to you. For me, I'm not, you know what I'm saying? Like, me personally, all of this could have been avoided. Every single situation I've seen could have been avoided. I'm not gonna lie to you. But hey, that's their life, man. It's whatever. But if you're new here, like, comment, subscribe. I'm about to start doing reactions and stuff like that. So put some, like, links in the bio of what y'all want me to react to. And we'll go from there, see how this do. Trying to get back on my YouTube buzz, for me. I'm not really streaming lately, but I might get back into it as well. So if y'all know, if y'all like streaming and shit like that, streamers, Just Jalen on Twitch. Actually, I'm about to go to Kick. So Just Jalen on Kick type shit. But I ain't gonna cap to you. We out.